Hello, hi. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Luisa. Thank you for inviting me.
Okay, Doc, balitaan mo kami. Ano ba to? Ano ba tong bagong technology ba ito? At aba, nare-rejuvenate pala ang ari ng mga babae. At anong mga benefits na makukuha mula dito?
Oo. Actually, Luisa, no, so akala mo psychology lang, no? Actually, we have Well, laser and gynecology, we've been using it actually pati sa obstetrics nga eh. But however, we expanded the use of laser in terms of now we're using it to, we call it laser vaginal rejuvenation. So it's actually a procedure wherein you use laser machine to enhance the vaginal health. So ano ba yung mga target namin dito? Usually, you can address with lasers, you can, di ba parang sa inyo, di ba yung laser, you use it for the skin, for the face, but on our end, of course, we use it sa vaginal canal to one, actually tighten the vagina. The number two, also it can address yung tinatawag naming GSM, genitourinary syndrome of menopause. So this is a condition wherein you use laser to increase, di ba, yung collagen formation such that you actually help in the vaginal lubrication and at the same time prevent mga conditions such as minsan common to Luisa eh, recurrent urinary tract infection. Common to among menopause eh. And it's really not really yung usual infectious na alam mo. So the laser can also help the vaginal health, especially amongst menopausal women. And of course, also it can also help yung mga bladder symptoms na recurrent UTI because of again menopause, so yon. So it's not only for it's also for tightening, it's for overall increase in the suppleness and youthful vagina.
Galing, no?
So hindi lang sa skin, 'di ba? Oo, inagaw na namin yung ano nyo.
Kung
So actually there are different lasers in the market. So depends on, well, in St. Luke's Medical Center, we have actually what we have is the Photona, which is an Erbium laser. So there are also other forms of laser, but in our institution, kasi we've, ano na, this is actually one of the safer laser for the vagina. Kasi syempre, all naman may mga side effects yan eh. So yeah, it can also be given, used amongst patients. Alam mo yung post delivery yung nanganak and they feel that, of course, the may mga changes, di ba? So they feel a little bit too loose. Alam mo, there's vaginal laxity. So pwede rin yan. Non-invasive.
Wow. So parang kumbaga sa aming mga dermatologists, anti-aging ng mga gynecologists, ano, nare-rejuvenate ang mga ari ng mga kababaihan. And sinabi mga doc, after delivery o post-delivery. Ano pa, Doc? Ano pa? Sabi dito ay, so this is with a laser, pero kayo rin ay nagsusurgical, tama?
Yes, oh, there are actually ano ne, the I'm actually an aesthetic I'm an aesthetic gynecologist. So what do we do? Kasi ito mga untouched to na ano eh, alam mo, you don't really
Talk about it.
talk about it. So there are actually non-surgical. So kasama sa non-surgical will be the laser. Also, we do like for those women na ano, we also use, sorry Luisa, baka sabi mo inaagawan ka namin. We do Botox in the vagina. So also, we can use,
Wow. I can't
and
believe
also
it.
filler.
Ngayon ko lang
Yeah, also
narinig
filler.
to ah, na merong ang tawag sa iyo, aesthetics gynecologist, pero ang pinapaganda
Yes,
mo is the vagina.
yes.
Okay, so binobotox at pinifiller mo rin ba? Tama?
Yeah, depende sa indication. Yeah, oo. So depende sa indication. So depends on the indication for the Botox. So for Botox kasi yung mga nagbabaginismus or merong non-relaxation of
Ano
the
yung vaginismus, Doc?
vagina.
Ano yung
Oh,
vaginismus?
sorry. Oh, nga. Vaginismus, so kumbaga it's a condition wherein there's uncontrollable spasm. Yung parang nagko-contract yung vagina ng mga babae such that hindi sila nakakapag-engage ng or they're not to have intimacy with their husbands or their partners. So yun. So what we do is try to relax the vagina. So of course, important din yan sa mag-asawa, especially sabi mo nga, ano, Hearts Month ngayon, February. So we do Botox on the vagina, and at the same time we can also do we use mga fillers. So, and also at the same time, may mga tinatawag kami mga G-shot, O-shot, so may mga ganon. So those are the non-surgical approach to improve vaginal health. Uh-huh. I mean, also not only laser. However, there is also mga surgical, approach. So yung aside from the usual repair, yung tightening na ginagawa, I also do labiaplasty. Mm-hmm. So if I don't know, for those na of course nanganak vaginally, or even ano ha, may mga inherent na never pa nagka-baby, never pa nanganak, they have excessive may tinatawag kaming labia, alam mo yung flap, so alam, women would do this, would know this, yung parang may excess skin.
Excess skin.
Yes, in the labia minora.
So parang Dumbo ear.
Also, yes, yung parang ears na ano. Uh-huh. So, and you know, patients would, you don't talk about this, but then it can also interfere with sexual intercourse, mm-hmm. Because if it's too big, yung complaint ng mga patients ko, they feel that the labia is rubbing.
Yeah.
And you know, causing them pain during intercourse. So that can be reduced. You call it labiaplasty.
Mm-hmm.
So will it, it's an
ginagamit din ba yan sa ating mga kababaihan, sinasabi na ano to, nanganak na hindi tinahe. Maririnig natin 'yon eh.
Yes. So maraming ways of ano no. So pag hindi tinahe, so we call it naman yung posterior repair. But also in our society, or for those who are, you know, trained with aesthetic gynecology, we do not only that, we also repair the perineum such that hindi lang yung sumikip, kumanda din. So usually we part of it will be perineography. So hindi lang yung tightening.
Okay.
Kasi ang problem pag tinighten mo, yeah, maganda din ngayon, but at the same time, di ba, akala mo yung face lang yung importante, sa baba din, it's very important.
Very important.
Women now are more conscious talaga. Oo.
For intimacy lalo na. So, ano yan, walang age, lalo na yung sa laser, kanina na binanggit mo, for rejuvenation.
Yes, oo. Actually, marami kasing approach eh, di ba, sa laser. I mean, depends on the application and the dose. So, I've used it sa mga younger women and also older women, mga menopause. Alam mo yung, since we're talking about vaginal health, no? I'm sure may mga viewers dito na mga ano, menopausal women. Ba't ako UTI ng UTI? Eh, malinis naman. Ako, yung iba nga, hindi ko contact. They claim that they don't have intimacy with their husbands. But then you give a lot of antibiotics. Hindi ito natatouch masyado eh. And usually, kasi what happens is that when you are menopause, you lack the estrogen.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So pag nawala yung estrogen,
or kahit perimenopause, doc, ha? Perimenopause. Ibig sabihin, going to the menopausal age, diba? Pwede na?
So ito kasi you ask about the age, diba? Uh-huh. So ito talaga yung mga 50s, 60s na.
Uh-huh.
Ah, alam mga, then they have UTI. So, one of the applications kasi din ng laser, lalo will be, kasi nga, pag nagmenopause ka, wala kang estrogen. Pag nawala yung estrogen mo, it promotes growth of the bad bacteria. That you change yung pH.
Okay.
That's why menopausal women are prone to UTI. So, isang application to kasi ng laser eh. So, it's not only aesthetic, but it has a function. We call it functional gynecology. So what the laser will do is actually it will promote collagen formation, so that you will, you know, rejuvenate the and go, bring back the vaginal health, increase ng yung vaginal mucosa, magiging youthful siya.
Uh-huh.
And also hindi painful ang intercourse, kasi syempre kahit naman din sabi nga ni Doc kanina, kahit naman menopausal o talagang ano na, mga senior natin, not all of them are, I mean, marami pa ding aware of their sexuality and, you know, practice their, ano, have sexual intimacy.
Okay, Doc, we only have 2 minutes to go. So, as my last question, Doc, so anong tawag sa katulad mo na parang dermatologist except ari ng babae ang pinapaganda mo?
Aesthetic gynecology.
Aesthetic gynecology.
Yeah, it's It's actually, ano yan eh, so even yung mga iba, pag tinanong, parang, what's, I mean, it's new, it's emerging, but we are a group actually, so... Okay.
Are you all over all over the Philippines, my aesthetic gynecologist, doc?
Well, yes, we are. But however, syempre, like kamukha sa inyo, we're also, since we use machines, so not all access. Centers will have machines. So limited lang din. But in St. Luke's Medical Center, we have a very good machine which can address all these problems.
Ayan. Doc, ang dami kong natutunan kahit ako hindi aware. Ah. Isa kang aesthetic. Pero... Di tayo magkalaban hanggang mukha lang ako, Doc. But thank you. Thank you for rejuvenating. Alam mo, nakakatuwa tong good news na to, Doc, dahil sa ating mga kababaihan, I'm sure madami sa kanila ang gustong magpatulong. So it's good news na meron po tayong mga aesthetic gynecologists. Hindi nga ito pinag-uusapan, pero ngayon ay nire-report na namin sa inyo mga kapamilya, maari kayong matulungan ni Doc. Ayan. So yan po mga kapamilya. Thank you, Doc. Thank you very much po. Yan po mga kapamilya, si Dr. Marie Cruz Javier, ang ating pong OB gynecologist from St. Luke's Medical Center.